awesome speech prior to going into that song. Two, because you made and melted the hearts of everyone standing behind you. And three, because I wouldn't be singing this song if it wasn't for a lot of your encouragement. So thanks for coming. Anyway, so the next song, if you're paying attention to the program, is Bridge Over Troubled Waters, Simon and Garfunkel. And for those of you who don't know, this is my first solo ever with SBS band. I'm really just playing around kicking and screaming as I'm being dragged up on the stage. You sit back down on your pew, comfortable. That was my first attempt at singing a solo. My second attempt singing a solo actually came senior year of high school. That was, you know, senior year, I'd overcome a lot of other barriers, you know, pretty confident, you know, talking to adults now, talking to other people. You know, those things that you develop in middle school and high school, those small things of courage that build up and make you confident. And so I thought I could do it, and then I tried out, which was just me and the other auditionees for some Les Mis song. I forget what it is even now. But I remember, like, I came in, I felt like I can do this, I'm nervous, but I can do this, I've been able to do everything else. And I got up there to sing, and my voice just kind of choked up, and I couldn't actually get the notes out. It was just a bunch of voice cracks, you know, wavering, trying to find the right note as I was singing the song. So that's the second time that I've ever tried to sing in front of people. The third time that I've ever tried to sing in front of people was actually freshman year, when I tried out with this group in the spring. And again, I have to attribute to some other people because you can only push yourself so far. But there are two people in the audience here who were in my room as I was singing for the third time in front of people in my life that I remember the solo that I was about to audition, which was Who Am I by Casting Crowns. That song still holds a very dear place in my heart. And then another two people walked me, and one of them was the same, walked me to the audition place. To actually audition my song and sat out there the whole time when I was singing my solo or my audition. Anyway, long story short, I'm an SBSB, surprise. I still, those first few years, I wasn't really sure what Kristen Chu, Grace Wang, and Stephen Hafferkamp saw in me or heard in me. I wasn't audible in SBSB practice. Richard mentioned that, you know, that first year it's a lot of musical learning. I mean, I had sung in a choir, but my objective was to hide behind the voices of the two louder basses on either side of me. So I was part of the choir, but even some people in the group haven't heard me really sing until Hakuna Matata, my only iconic solo. So this particular song, learning it and practicing it, when I first got it, I was a little surprised. It's hard for me to actually describe how surprised I was because there were some other voices in the group who really, really, really had this song down and sang it beautifully. But I still got the solo. I think somebody behind me believed in me and that I could do it. So when I first started practicing it, I was convinced, 100% convinced, that they would lower the key so I could hit the notes in the song. I was wrong. They did not. So I continued to practice trying to hit the keys and everything. And practice, at first, didn't really go so well. I struggled to make it through the song even with the music in front of me. And then Colin Adams, the guy who recorded the SBSB album, came, and he recorded everyone, and then he supervised the guy's songs. And he heard my voice, or heard me try to sing, and it was the same as it always has been. And he just said, "Oh, stop. You can hit that note." I'm like, "No, I have to switch into falsetto." No. You can hit that note. Here, try. And he just plays it on the piano, and he's quavering that note, like high, what is it, D or E or something like that? It's high, I'm telling you. And he's just quavering, and I don't get it the first time, and then he says, "All right, stop. Look at the faces of everyone around you. Like, they're all there for you. Every single one of them is there for you. Every single one of them is there for you." And then I saw, like, their laughter and their cheers and their encouragement, and I was able to, for the first time, hit that note without going falsetto. That's a big first step. It was also the first time that I realized that I could actually sing this song, because I realized that I accepted the solo without ever believing that I could sing. Long story short, I would have had, without the support of these guys, with those people standing there, or, without people in the audience, life who have helped and encouraged me. My time here in SPSB, I wouldn't be able to attempt. I at least belt a note out now, before it wasn't even come out. So whether or not the note's right, you'll hear me singing it loud. So anyway, Bridge Over Troubled Waters. I'd rather have no other song to have learned to sing.